no, no.
Carlos, te aviso los 5 minutos, ¿ok?
Ok, the next speaker is Carlos Málaga, Facultad de Ciencias UNAM, Intruders Interaction in a Granular Flow. Carlos.
Okay, thank you for the invitation. This ongoing work in collaboration with Gabriel Caballero and Francisco Manzano. And let me first say a word about Tim Minson. This is from a book of George Marshall, the bachelor of the classic fluid mechanics textbook, and I think it shows the bachelor's attitude towards applied mathematics, and I believe Tim Minson's attitude was very similar to this one. I heard about Minson when I was a student, but I did not attend his lectures. So until I became a teacher, I met him. He used to come around the physics department and see what we were doing, in particular in fluid mechanics in my case. And he was always eager to tell us something, to share his knowledge on this subject, which was amazing how much he knew about this. Okay, so let me tell you about the objective of this collaboration. The idea is to study lift forces produced by a granular flow flowing between or around two solid intruders. This and the flow upstream is uniform, and the idea is that we have experiments that show some interesting features of the behavior of these forces, and we also have a higher dynamic model that we hope will provide some explanation of what we experiment with. So the first motivation of this on this problem is that this setup is a known setup used in fluid mechanics, and it's been used to understand the hydrodynamic interactions of intruders in a flow that is uniform upstream and involves drops and particles inside the fluid. And the idea is that we have moderate Reynolds numbers, and the flow is something that we have a steady flow around the obstacles. And what you find is that if they are too close together, they feel a repulsive interaction. And as you put them away, as you move them away, then you this force changes sign, and you have a weak attraction that fades away as you move them further away. Okay. If you reduce the Reynolds number, then the distance you need for the change of sign in the lift force increases. You have to move them further apart to see this attractive interaction. And the force becomes even weaker. So in the limit of zero Reynolds number, it stops flow, then you have no attraction. You have just repulsion. So in the case of granular flow, this setup that's been used so much in the fluid flow, it hasn't been used in granular flow. And mostly what's been studied is the drag forces on intruders in a granular flow. And it's known that there are long range interactions, for example, when you're shaking grains and they segregate these. So this led Gabriel Caballero and co-workers to study the interactions when you make heavy intruders impact a very lightweight granular material, and this was inspired on a work by an experiment by Carlos Ruiz when he dropped different groups of intruders in a styrofoam granular material. So they did some experiments. Many experiments tried to see what was going on and what the interactions were. And it turned out to be a very complicated system and a very complicated phenomenon because it was time dependent on the height, on the relative speeds, and so on. So they found it was hard to understand the interaction between intruders. But they found that you have a portion where there's sort of jamming in between the intruders, and you have attraction when there is a sort of Bernoulli effect.
These are the
stress changes on the material. These are medical solutions.
What's a stress change?
So the forces on the contact on the grains.
Okay, I'll ask my question.
Okay, so you see these lines normally touch. When they stop, they touch the boundaries. So that means that the intruders are leaning on grains that are leaning on other grains, and they end up leaning on the wall. This arching, it's called. So it's all the weight of the intruder is being spread around the system, and it ends up in there.
Okay.
So they're watching how this the weight is being transferred. In terms.
So originally it's just the gravity.
Yeah, it's gravity. Gravity.
When it's down, there's no gravity. Sometimes.
Sorry?
When the two intruders are downstream, there's no gravity.
There's still gravity, but you mean when they stop?
There's no forces that they push the forces down. No forces. When right now on the left.
Yeah, here.
There's no forces in that.
Well, the weight of the intruder is balanced by the grains that rests on the bottom of the. Okay. Okay. So they found this was too complicated. Gabriel tried a different thing, so the same numerical scheme, which is a 2D screen method. In the previous case, it was the styrofoam is supposed to be so light that you have to include drag, the air drag in the simulations. So he did all the simulation where they kept the intruders fixed, and he controlled the flow of stream by making this periodic and including some things to stop and regulate the flux of the ions. And so control the flow to the U infinity that I showed. So what they tried to see whether there was a value effect governing the attraction. So what they did is they explored regions around the intruders to see if the average, and to define a difference between the square of the velocities, to see if they can correlate the forces, the lift force, with the difference of the speeds around the objects, the intruders. So what they found is, contrary to what Bernoulli would have suggested, is that the best correlation was when they didn't explore the equator, both sides of the equator or the equator, but upstream and a little bit upstream. And they actually found that there was a strong correlation of the lift force with this difference defined in these inner and outer regions, but divided by the power between halves of the upstream velocity. It's a pretty good correlation. When FL is positive, they have a repulsion, and when it's negative, it's traction. So this is not a Bernoulli effect. We're now working with a real experiment. So we have a 2-sheet acrylic, one inch thick, to avoid deformations. This is a side view. There are the intruders that have some force transducers to measure things. And this is the diameter. So we're exploring different separations. And we are using tapioca seeds as the granular material. Tapioca seeds are fairly monodispersed. They're fairly spherical. And above all, they are gluten free. So this is video of what's going on. So it's, they get somehow stuck in here when they flow. This is an agriculture.
This produces agriculture.
Okay, so so these are the results. So so we do find some. So this is the lift force as function of the flow upstream for different values of the separation. So we actually see that if the flow is more, yes, the flow is more intense, then we pass from attraction to repulsion as they get stuck and trying to, they jam, trying to cross the space between the two. Okay. And this is the going a bit fast. This is the other way of showing the data. So this is the lift force as function of the separation of the intruders for different upstream velocities. So you see the repulsion to the attraction is away. So this resembles some hydrodynamic solutions in the case of the intruders. So we have this observation. And this is what we see here. This is, for example, the case of three radius of separation between the intruders. Here you have the variance of the velocity. This is the so-called granular temperature. Okay. So this is the case of where you feed is 5 centimeters per second, and this corresponds to an attractive interaction. And as you see, the velocity has a maximum between the intruders, and the temperature, the granular temperature, shows a lot of agitation around these intruders. And when we speed up the process, then there's a compulsion, and so this maximum is dragged down behind below the intruders, and then you have jamming or something like that. Around here, then you have this propulsion interaction. And the temperature has this shape. Okay, so this is partial conclusions. The conclusions are that we have a simple system with a glitch that sits in it, and we believe that the propulsion is caused by jamming, and actually it doesn't seem to be a Bernoulli effect. And so we look for a hydrodynamic model that can help us understand what's going on. So this is the model. So this model is based on some kinetic theory for inelastic particles, Jenkins and Savage. So they're considered by binary collisions. The particles can deform a little bit, and so we developed some continuous model for the flow of granular material, and from this work they have lots of developments. So we use a modified version that resembles a hydrodynamic model. So it's basically this, which is a momentum equation, very much like a fluid dynamics equation, and an equation for the temperature. So the equation for the temperature has what would be the viscous heating term, which is a stress tensor, as it is in fluid mechanics, contracted with the greater strain tensor. So this is there's some dissipation, so lambda is a coefficient. And there it has this extra term that is a coefficient of temperature loss. So if everything is everything comes to rest, then this will make temperature go to zero. Okay. Besides that, you have some pressure and transfer coefficient expressions. And that was the idea of Savage and Jenkins, that they wanted to provide a continuum model that would relate directly to the media, to the granular media, to the size of the grains, to etc. So there is an expression for the pressure that affects the temperature and the density of the grains and its functions. The viscosity is also related to temperature, the diameter of the grains, its functions, and the same happens with the other transport coefficients, the dissipation and the energy loss. E is the restitution coefficient. Okay? And these functions are functions of phi. Phi is the solid solid volume fraction. And these functions grow very fast as the solid volume fraction reaches the close packing limit. Really condensed. So, and these are actually for these functions, the Carnahan, the Carnahan-Starling formula that is on the previous topic is normally used because it goes really fast. So we have is the model, and we need to know what's going on with phi in order to solve the problem. So we follow what the E, and these are actually this, if you see the work of such, these functions are very similar. So if you assume that you assume that they are basically the same, then you can substitute pressure on the expressions of the transport coefficient. So transport coefficients are given in terms of pressure or temperature. And so numerical values, lambda c or eta c or epsilon c. Okay? So then you can solve them. You can solve them all, at least numerically. Okay? There's one problem. When you try to solve the momentum equation, then pressure can have any value at least. So it's not really specified at the beginning. So pressure doesn't behave really like this, because at rest this should go to zero. So we have to include some sort of characteristic-based pressure to work with this. So we use a classic result low rate of solar flow past the cylinder. So in this way we have a base pressure that can adjust to any initial condition on the flow on top, and with Reynolds number. So we solve the temperature equation with finite differences and the momentum equation, and that's also the model. The Latin-Boltzmann model solves indirectly the momentum equation an incompressible flow through approximation of the Boltzmann equation. This discretizes the version of the VEK approximation. So the amounts of the distribution are related to the velocity of pressure, and the results are approximate solutions. And we use a procedure that uses the momentum exchange provided by boundary conditions on the intervals to compute the force. Okay, and the good thing about this is it's very, very efficient when you're doing when you compute everything in parallel.
And this is 3D?
This is 2D.
This is 2D.
What happened to 3D?
Sorry?
What happened to 3D?
Ah, nice. We will see. So the experiment is very narrow, so we are starting with the numerics can be used in 3D with not huge difficulty. You just need more computing power. So these are the computations. We start from the Newtonian flow, from the steady Newtonian flow. So this temperature initially zero. We have zero flux conditions on the temperature, on the boundaries, and on the intruders. We have the usual non-slip conditions on the intruders here, very low velocity. And we have, we pulse the flow here, Reynolds number here. And we have zero shear rate, zero strain rate on the rest of the boundaries. Okay. So we let that go. Did it reach some stationary solution? Okay. So we see that the evolution of temperature and the evolution of the velocity. And if you remember what I showed you from the experiments, previously, then this case, the case I just showed you, turned out to produce an attractive interaction. So if you compare it with an attractive case in the real experiment, then we see that this qualitatively the model does well. And the velocity field is pretty similar to the state. And we'll do the same experiment with a stronger upstream flow, then we do get repulsion, but we didn't get nothing similar to what we saw in the actual experiments. So apparently, the jamming thing is not well reproduced by the model. Okay, so what we get, the pictures we get in the case of a stronger flow with repulsive interaction are pretty similar to this one. They're just dragged down a bit by the flow, but they are not so radically different as in the case of the real experiment. If we look for the correlation of the lift and this equation using the same idea they did, so exploring these two regions above the intruders, then we see something that might suggest some correlation between the force and these things. So we're still working, so I wish I could give you some conclusion of this. So,
thank you.
Thank you, Carlos.
In the first part, experimental part of the presentation, you showed some plots, balances,
the force
on distance between the fixed and others.
Mm-hmm.
Amazingly similar to potential curves. But if such analogy is reasonable, there must be a certain moment where those plots which have minimum just should get type of bound states, which correspond to the distance of the atomic molecule.
Okay.
So no repulsion, no attraction, but a bound state. Isn't something special here? When you go from regime of the full repulsion to the regime when attraction occurs, then this well. So there is very specific physical point of view. Of bounds. It corresponds to a certain amount of attraction you have there.
I don't know, we haven't looked close to these
We haven't looked close. Another question is just related to this. You consider the case of two intruders.
Yeah.
What would happen if you have three?
I have no idea.
You
mean different arrays? Not all in line? Or
just whatever. Simply three things.
Something
very special should occur. So the transition from two body to three body is qualitative. It's just something trivial physics.
I understand. Yes, we're trying first to understand or to justify through the model the force, especially this power to the three halves. But because we have now, we did model have an expression that relates strain rate with temperature, if it works, of course. So if we can justify, for example, doing a dimension and something, these relations, then I guess then we'll try to let them go, for example. That's something that maybe we can do. Or include more interactions. So it's a very good suggestion.
Questions?
I have first the comment. You said that the simulations break down for the when they get stagnant. I mean the last part of your talk, yeah.
The last.
Yeah, the repulsion is not well.
Yeah. So it looks like this, but it doesn't.
Could it be in the Boltzmann model you treat the particles as points?
You mean in the numerics?
In the numerics?
No. It's a continuum. So we're solving the continuum.
Because you mentioned
solving this, as if it were fluid.
Right, but the simulations.
The other ones, the previous.
You got
the ones that Gabriel did.
At some point you said that you used the Boltzmann lattice model.
That was to solve.
Sorry
about the confusion. That was to solve the continuous model equation.
Right. So it may break down because I can imagine that model may be very singular when there is a lot of stagnation.
I'm sorry if I said it wrong. It doesn't break down.
I mean,
it just doesn't reproduce.
Well, I mean, it's not a good. I mean to say perhaps it's very singular. You know,
sorry.
It may be very singular. It has, you know, the lattice model, the behavior, because then you have stagnations. You have a lot of particles with small velocity. There may be the model, the lattice numerical approximation may not be.
That is not a difficult problem.
Yeah.
No. It can solve stagnant flow. Stagnation points, and the intruders are not moving, so they don't really get close. So they are fixed, so they don't move close to each other. If they were to move close to each other, if they were free and they move close, we would have a problem with the numerics, definitely, as they approach. We have to do something like this. I don't know if
that answers the question. Any other questions? Let's thank Carlos again.